Hello students, today we are going to learn the second page of your second chapter, and the name of the chapter is How Daddy Was Always Late. So yesterday we learned that little daddy was always late. He never wanted to do his homework. He used to read his story books, and his grandpa and grandma would be very angry with him, and at last they used to snatch his book from him and told and say to him that he was a lazy fellow and he would end up as a good for nothing guy, and thus little daddy would feel offended. Then he would weep and cry and demand his book to give him his book back. Okay, that was what we learned in our previous class. So today we shall continue from the second page. Let's start. He said that he wouldn't start his homework until they gave it back to him, and so the evening would slip away. When little daddy finally sat down to do his homework, he would fall asleep. He did this homework in a daze. By the time he was through it, it would really be late. So what happened? So daddy used to cry and he demand his story book, and he used to threaten his grandpa and grandma that if they don't return his story book, he wouldn't do the homework, he wouldn't complete the homework. So by doing all these excuses, his evening would slip away. And when little daddy finally at the evening, when he used to sit to complete his homework, he was very tired, he would to feel sleepy, and he always did his homework in a daze. And what is daze? Daze means in a confused state. When you are feeling too sleepy, your brain is not working properly, you cannot do your exercises properly. So he was always in a daze while he was doing his homework. By the time he was through it, it would be really late. So in the morning, when he would complete his homework in a daze, because at the evening he would sleep, okay, he would fall asleep. So in the morning, in the daze, in a daze, in a confused state, when he would do his homework, it was slow work. He used to do it very slowly, and he used to make mistakes also, and he was always late. Okay. Grandpa and grandma would be exhausted. So grandpa and grandma, what happened? They would be very tired of him, tired of scolding him, tired of correcting him, tired of advising him. In the morning, it was a different story. Get up, grandma would say. Wait a second, little daddy would mumble. So in the morning, he wouldn't like to come out from his bed. Okay, grandma would tell him to wake up, but he would mumble. Now what is mumble? Mumble means speak in a quiet and unclear voice. So he was in half sleep and he used to mumble that I will not get up, let me sleep 5 minutes and 5 minutes more. So have you old people also do like that, isn't it? So little daddy also used to do like it. Get up, grandma would shout. Wait a second, you are late. So when grandma used to shout, wake up, then little daddy used to say, please wait a second, let me sleep for some more minutes. And it is continued every day, every morning. Everyone knows how hard it is to get up when you went to bed late the night before. You have all your sweetest dreams in the morning, especially if you have to go to school. So if you sleep late in the evening, then it is very difficult to get up early in the morning. It is very difficult. So grandma tells him that you should have sweet dreams and you should sleep nicely, so that in the early in the morning you can go to school in a fresh mood. Time marched steadily on while little daddy stretched and yawned and pulled his clothes on, sleepily washed, dozed through his breakfast, and finally managed to get his books together. So time marched steadily means time doesn't wait for anyone. We already know that a proverb, time and tide waits for none. So time won't wait for little daddy. So time would go on continue, and here little daddy would stretch and yawn. What is stretch and yawn? To just stretch your body after getting sleep, okay, and yawn, okay, and pulled his clothes on, and he used to pull his clothes. He sleepily was, then he used to go to the bathroom very sleepily, very lazily, everything very slowly, okay. Then he used to sit near his breakfast. He was very in a lazy mood. He used to eat it, and doing all these things, he would be very late for school. Since little daddy did his homework at the last minute, he never did it well. As I told you earlier, that always little daddy used to do his homework in the last minute. At the last minute means when it was almost late, he used to complete his homework at the last minute. So it was always full of mistakes. Since he was always late for school, he often missed the teacher's explanation of a new subject. So since he was always late in the school, he always used to miss the new subject explanation by a teacher. Okay, when a teacher used to explain a new subject, a new chapter, he was always late. He never made it. He never used to come in time. This made it harder for him to understand what the rest of the class was doing. So he was so what happened when he is not attentive in class, when he is late in the classes, he was always not able to understand what was actually going on in the class, because he was sometimes late, he was sometimes absent, he doesn't attend the classes. Little daddy was always late all his life. So not only in his childhood, when little daddy grew up in his youth days and in his latter days also, he was always late. He was late for school, late for college, late for work. So when he started doing job, he was also late there. He lost out many things in life because of this awful habit. So in his life, if he was not late, if he was an active man, he would have gained many things. But because of this awful habit, awful means very hard, very bad habit, okay. His friends love, he lost many things in his life because of this very bad habit. His friends love to tell funny stories about his being late. So his friends used to make fun of him. They used to mock him. They used to laugh at telling stories about him. Even now, daddy doesn't know how to walk slowly. He's always in a hurry because he is used of being late. So when you are late for something, you used to walk in a hurry. Come, let's go quickly. Is it not? You should walk in a hurry. You do work in a hurry in the last moment. Same like this, little daddy, still now he doesn't know how to walk slowly because he was always late and always in a hurry. Okay, so we learn from this chapter that if you are a lazy person, if you don't do your work actively, you will face many problems in your life and you will miss out many good opportunities in your life. So the moral of the story is that we should be active and we should work hard, work in time, we should be punctual to gain success in life. Okay, student, that's all for today. That's the end of the chapter. In your next class, I will be teaching you the third chapter of your English book. Okay, thank you.